Kangaroos are marsupials, which are an infraclass of mammals. Marsupials are unique in that they carry their underdeveloped young in an abdominal pouch. The babies are born after just a few weeks of gestation and continue their development in the pouch until they are strong enough to emerge into the outside world. Kangaroos include four species that are mostly indigenous to Australia. These species are the red kangaroo, the antilopine kangaroo, the eastern gray kangaroo, and the western gray kangaroo. Another species of marsupial, the tree kangaroo, inhabits Papua New Guinea. Red kangaroos are the largest in the world. They typically grow over 5 feet or 1.5 meters tall. Exceptionally, some can grow up to 6.9 feet or 2.1 meters tall and weigh as much as 200 pounds. That's 90 kilograms. They can hop on their strong, muscular hind legs, reaching speeds of up to 37 miles an hour. All kangaroos are strict herbivores and can be seen grazing grass, using their thick, powerful tails as a third back leg for balance. They have short forelimbs, which can be used in their characteristic behavior of boxing and wrestling. They also balance solely on their tails whilst they deliver powerful kicks with their hind legs. Males often fight like this to gain access to receptive females and assert their dominance. Kangaroos can inflict serious injuries on people by boxing or kicking them. Attacks from kangaroos, however, are rare unless they are provoked. Whilst kangaroos are mostly endemic to Australia, here we ask the question, could they survive in Africa? To answer this question, we need to consider several factors. These include climate, habitat, and food that would be available to kangaroos in Africa, as well as any potential competition or predators. So, firstly, let's look at the climate. Australia has a range of climates across its 3.3 million square mile landmass. In its center, Australia is a largely hot desert. In the north, mostly savanna, with oceanic and subtropical climates in the east, Mediterranean in the south, and cold desert and semi-arid regions throughout. There are plenty of countries in Africa that would offer a similar climate to Australia. In the north, countries like Algeria, Libya, and Egypt offer arid hot desert conditions, whilst more central countries like Congo and the DRC typically comprise tropical rainforests and savanna. More temperate climates are found in Africa's southern regions. With such varying climates, Africa offers a range of temperatures and levels of precipitation that are comparable to Australia. In an average year, the hottest country in Africa is Ethiopia, whilst the coolest is Lesotho, resulting in lush green rainforests, hot, dry deserts, and everything in between. Now, if we consider habitat, the different species of kangaroo live in different habitats, but they generally stay in areas where there is plentiful vegetation for them to eat. The red kangaroo is mostly found in the rangelands of western New South Wales and within arid and semi-arid regions. The western gray kangaroos live in forests, savanna, grassland, and shrubland. Eastern grays prefer areas with higher rainfall, with plenty of foliage and trees for cover, as well as open plains for feeding. And antilopine kangaroos frequent unwooded plains. Africa offers this kind of diversity, from the vast, open savannas and grasslands of South Africa, Botswana, Kenya, and Tanzania, to the forests and wetter regions found in Africa's eastern highlands, the Congo and Gabon. Kangaroos could survive in many of these habitats. Integrated with the kangaroo's habitat is their food. Considering the preferred food of kangaroos, we know that there would be an abundance across many parts of Africa, especially in the open plains and savannas. Kangaroos are strict herbivores and mostly graze grasses. The red kangaroo also browses various bushes and flowering plants. They graze Australia's open grasslands during the coolness of dusk or dawn, or at nighttime. If we just look at the climate, habitat, and food available across Africa, it is likely that kangaroos could survive. But what about competition from other animals? And what about predators? Australia is home to more than 40 million kangaroos. If they were to inhabit Africa, there may be stiff competition with other herbivores. In Africa, These herbivores include a huge variety of different species, including antelope, wildebeest, zebras, rhinos, elephants, and hippos. With kangaroos grazing or browsing the African savannas and bush, they would occupy similar niches to Africa's native herbivores. Could Africa cope with yet another grazer on its open plains? Probably, but it may create pressure on those animals already found there. This could have a knock-on effect, as each organism, plant or animal, shuffles and readjusts to the changes that the introduction of kangaroos would cause. Furthermore, Australia doesn't have any large land predators. Of course, those in the water include crocodiles and many shark species, and Australia is home to some of the world's most venomous snakes, including 20 of the top 25. But its largest land predator is the dingo. This wild dog was introduced to Australia by Asian seafarers approximately 4,000 years ago, so technically it's not a native species. However, they are well cemented in the ecosystem. Dingoes hunt wallabies, wombats, birds, reptiles, and kangaroos. They can hunt in a pack, making them capable of taking down the large red kangaroos as well. However, before the introduction of dingoes, there were few land predators that Australia's wildlife had to look out for. In southern Australia, there once lived a terrifying marsupial lion that became extinct around 30,000 years ago. They were carnivores weighing up to 290 pounds that had a bite force comparable to today's lions. These animals would have preyed upon kangaroos, especially the giant kangaroos that once roamed the Australian outback. But because Australia is separated from the ancient landmass Gondwana 65 million years ago, Australia's wildlife was allowed to evolve into an incredible and often bizarre array of unique species, without influence from too many predators or invasive wildlife. These unique species include, but are not limited to, the duck-billed platypus, the echidna, the Tasmanian devil, the bandicoot, and, of course, the kangaroo. Australia's wildlife is incredibly vulnerable to invasive species due to its evolutionary isolation. For this reason, the Australian government is very strict about what enters the country. This suggests that some of Australia's species wouldn't fare too well in the Great African Wilderness, where there are predators aplenty. They may not have the evasive capabilities that some of Africa's native prey display. They would have to adapt to a new position in the food chain. Although they can travel up to speeds of 37 miles an hour and can kick with incredible force, kangaroos would likely be no match for Africa's apex predators. Lions, wild dogs, hyenas, cheetahs, and leopards could consider kangaroos prey. These predators hunt the herbivores found on the African plains and in the bush, the same kind of habitats that kangaroos would call home. Kangaroo populations, however, would likely remain stable, despite pressures from predation. A female kangaroo can support multiple babies all at different stages in their development. She can be pregnant with a fetus in the womb, have a second baby developing in her pouch, and be nursing an older baby on the ground. This means that their reproductive cycles are rapid, and females can mother many offspring in a lifetime. In Australia, kangaroos are considered pests. There are approximately twice as many kangaroos as people living in Australia. Because these marsupials graze grassland, farmers consider them competition for their grazing livestock. As far as their ecological impact goes, kangaroos are soft-footed, unlike the hardened hooves of sheep and cattle. As a result, they are less likely to trample vegetation and damage soil. Even so, their large numbers can lead to culls across Australia. Some are farmed for their meat. And with climate change and drier conditions becoming more common across Australia, they may prove to be a more suited agricultural animal than the less well-adapted sheep and cattle. What would the impact of kangaroos be on the African wilderness if they were introduced to the continent? Would they outcompete the other herbivores that call Africa home? Or would they live side by side with the likes of zebra, impala, blesbok, and kudu? There may be an abundance of habitat available to kangaroos across the African savannas, but each ecosystem on this planet is made up of a delicate balance of organisms. Any disruption in this balance could prove devastating. In conclusion, we believe that kangaroos would survive and thrive in Africa. Their adaptability to hot and arid climates and their herbivorous lifestyle would serve them well on the African plains. However, one question remains. Would Africa survive the introduction of the kangaroo? That's all for today. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share it with your friends. You can also leave a comment with what you would like to see in the following videos. Thanks for watching. See you next time.